Welcome to Analytics with Nags. This is another Visuals with Nag video where I'm going to explain about ribbon chart. As you can see, the ribbon chart looks like this. And what is this and when to use it? Let us check it out in our next slide. So when to use a ribbon chart? It's basically you can create a ribbon charts to visualize data and quickly discover which data category has the highest rank. It, in a glance, when you see it over the period, right, in the chart, when you're seeing which data category is the highest one. So the chart will show always the highest one at the top. That is what a ribbon chart is all about. Ribbon charts are effective at showing a rank change. So another reason is like during the period, from one quarter to another quarter, there will be a change in ranks, right? That also you can easily able to visualize over each time period. What I'm trying to say about, let's try to check it out here. Like over here, this whatever is the top 113, right? So which is always at the top, that is what it is. Ranks, highest ranks always at the top. So here in this case 230, that becomes the highest now. So at each period, each point over a period, whichever be the highest category of value, that will appear first. And also when you check this particular change or transition, where you can see here, this is being the lowest here, right? And you can able to see the transition, it becomes a second now. So like this transition, you can easily identify in this chart. That is what a ribbon chart is all about. Let us try to check it out how we can implement in Power BI. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button. Since 60% of this channel viewers are not yet subscribed, so that you can support my efforts. Let's go to Power BI and you can see here the data. This is typical Nagastore data that we have shared earlier in my previous videos, and I will upload this video as well. So what it contains, it contains sale date and item number, item name and the data. Now what we are going to do is like just go to the ribbon chart. Okay, let's try to view it to the whole view over here. And I want to see the item quantity, how much it has sold, and across a different time frame. So I will put year and year, I mean date column. I will remove the quarter and day. Let's hope to keep only at the month level. So viewing this one will give you only at the bar chart like look like. I mean to say there is no category to view to differentiate. See, basically it says whichever category is the highest over the period. So you do not have any category. So it just shows your bar chart. So in the legend area, if you bring any of the category, the first category I want to view is location. As soon as you bring this location in the legend, you can see the value over here, right? The difference and changes. Where you can see the value Chennai, which is having 230, and whereas here 205 and 207 during this period is highest, right? Let us try to view the value why it's not appearing. Data label. Let me enable data label and filter out some of the data so that we can able to analyze much easier. So let me focus only on 2019. Then let me change some colors. Let me have you can change the properties. So that's what I'm trying to explain it here. So this seems to be little okay, fine. So what this ribbon chart says, so always whichever is the top quantity, right, in 19 March, this category 230 is the top value, highest value, that will be in the top portion, highest ranking. In 2019 April, this particular value 207, that is Bangalore, is the highest value, that becomes the first. And you can see the transition, right? So if you highlight this particular, between these 2 months, if you highlight this point, there is a change in rank, that is one rank changed, right? Rank change is equal to 1, that is greater than symbol 1 from the bottom I'm reading. And you can see it becomes, in 2019 April, it becomes 1. Earlier in 2019 March, Bangalore is in the second rank. This is in second rank, now it moved to first rank. So you can track two things, which is highest at any given point of time. And you can see the transition as well. So this is what chart is all about. Now you can see here, the rank changes to. The last time we see the increase, right? Rank is increased from the Bangalore is increased from second place to first place here. In this case, you can see this is decreased two place here, right? Rank change to from the 1 to 3rd rank. And this month you have highest rank as Chennai. This is what this chart is all about. So the categorical value you can able to view either location. I can put now use instead of category wise different category name. I mean whether it's accessories, casual, or when you put by category, there is no much changes. I mean it depends upon your business. Let us reach to by location itself. And some of the properties to highlight, like these are the common properties you can change about. Just now we saw the legend, I mean the data labels. The legend is at the top, this is fine. And one of the two important properties I want to highlight, zoom slider, where when you have this one, sometimes it will be very small changes, you cannot able to highlight which one it is. So in those cases, you can use this zoom slicer. I will maximize this so that you can go here and navigate and keep the change. You can check that a value. So this is one of the important property. Then another property is like slicer ribbons, right? Ribbons. So here you can define the space, how much space you want between the categories. So you can increase the space, match series color. So here, once you change this, it will, the look will be completely different. You can increase the transparency. If I keep 80%, you can see not 80%, it is 80. Now you can see the difference between the each month, the transparency is increased. So usually it will be 20 or 25, maybe 30 will be better. 30 is good. And if you want to add border, you can add it. So these are the two important properties, ribbons and the zoom slider, you can opt for in this visual. I hope you like this video and understand when to use ribbon chart. Hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.